Hi, my name is Willyn Webb, and I'm the author of Baby, the Poodle Cow Dog. I wanted to write this story to share with you some inspiration. Have you ever felt too little, too afraid, or too out of place to even try? Well, the story you're about to hear is true, and it may change your mind about trying. It's about my daughter and her amazing pet poodle, who became Baby, the Poodle Cow Dog, right before our very amazed eyes. It's amazing what can happen with a little bit of faith and a big dose of determination. There may be some words in the story that you're not familiar with. When you read it, you'll see them in bold type and you can look at them in the glossary. Or I'd love to Skype into your classroom and answer all of your questions when we're finished. Or talk to an adult, or use the internet, but always find out the meaning of words whenever you read a book. And don't forget that whether you look the part or not, if you'll always try and give it your best, even the most unlikely dreams can come true. So sit back, enjoy the ride, as I share with you Baby, the Poodle Cow Dog. It was 3 days before Christmas on the Cross V Ranch in Colorado. A little cowgirl named Skylin had a big problem. She didn't know what to ask Santa to bring her. Riding, roping, and rodeo were more important to her than baby dolls and toys. What will a cowgirl ask Santa to bring her? Skylin worried. But on Christmas morning, a little black puppy came running around the corner. It had a big red bow and a card. Merry Christmas, cowgirl. Mommy, Daddy, Santa knew not to bring me a doll. He brought me a cow dog. Skylin picked that tiny critter up. He licked her cheek, and they fell in love. The problem was that the puppy was a poodle, not a cow dog breed. The dogs on the ranch were working cow dogs, border collies with names like Homer and Ace. That kind of name does not fit, Skylin told her dad. This little poodle is so different. What am I going to name him? The next morning, Skylin had the little critter sitting in the old doll bed. Mama came in from chores and laughed. She played along and asked, Skylin, how's your baby? Skylin lit up. Baby! That's the perfect name. Well, one problem was solved, but another was about to begin. Baby just did not fit in. There were 5 border collies working on the Cross V Ranch. At first, they just stared at Baby, probably thinking, what is this sorry excuse for a dog? That little ball of fluff couldn't hurt a flea. Then a few tried to chase him away. They were probably thinking something like, he's as annoying as a field full of cuckleburrs. Then they just ignored him. Only Meg, one of the best border collies on the ranch, seemed to help Baby. She snuggled him close on cold Colorado nights. She let him play with her. Maybe Meg gave him a few cow punching tips as well. But nothing could change the fact that he was a poodle. Skylin never planned on taking Baby around the ranch. What if a cow kicks? What if my horse sidesteps? It could be dangerous for such a little dog. But nothing stopped Baby. That poodle would not let Skylin hit the trail without him. Trotting, loping, or making dust at top speed, somehow Baby always got to the cows. Was he trying to prove his name a mistake? Did he think he was a border collie? All around the ranch, Skylin and Baby helped out. Well, roundup time rolled around. Everyone was excited. Skylin and her sisters had been riding on the ranch all summer, and they thought they should get to go. Mommy, Daddy, Papa, can we go this year? They begged. You are bigger, said her dad, but Skylin is the oldest. Her mom added, she rides as good as any hand. Please, said Skylin. It's a long day, said Papa, but we need all the help we can get. I think Skylin is ready. Skylin cheered, yahoo! She would be riding on the mountain. Her sisters didn't get to go, and that made it even better. But the cowboys and cowgirls from the other ranches would be there. Skylin wondered, What would they think of a little cowgirl? Would the real cowboys and cowgirls just laugh? The big day came. Skylyn stood at the back of the trailer waiting to load her horse. Baby saw his chance. Believe it or not, that little poodle jumped in the back of the pickup with all the real cow dogs. Landed right beside Homer. Now Homer was the biggest, toughest, best cow dog on the ranch. Homer was known by all the ranch hands from all the ranches. The dog's thoughts seemed obvious. How's that tiny thing gonna gather a stray? What will the other ranch dogs think? He's sure not tough enough to face a mean bull. Pushing baby calves down the trail be too much for him. This is going to be embarrassing. Meg looked at Baby and shook her head. Could Meg help Baby today? Could she protect him? All dogs must know that ranch work is only for the smartest, toughest, and best of dogs. All dogs, that is, except Baby. Too late. The truck started moving. Papa, the owner and cow boss, drove the Cross V crew to the summer range on the top of Grand Mesa. Skylyn usually loved listening to the cowboys and cowgirls talk, but today was different. Was she ready? Could she handle the mountain? Her thoughts raced as the truck and trailer slowly climbed the mountain curves. They were the first ones to arrive. Baby jumped out. Skylyn saw him. Oh no, Baby, not today. Proving yourself a real hand was going to be hard. I'm ready to give it a go, but can you do it too? Skylyn asked Baby. Then she asked herself, will he even be safe? He wagged that little tail. You and I are becoming true cowhands, aren't we? Even if we don't look like it. But Baby was okay at home, but the real test was the mountain today. Papa was sitting on his big black horse when he spotted Baby. How did he get here? Papa looked worried. Skylyn took a deep breath. Papa, can Baby go on the roundup too? It's dangerous, Papa warned. Skylyn explained, he really is tough. What if he gets in the way? Papa questioned. He can help, Skylyn said with confidence. Papa did not want any trouble for Skylyn. This is going to be a big day for you. Are you sure you want to mess with that poodle? I am sure, said Skylyn. Papa replied, okay, we're burning daylight. It was time. Papa lined out all the cowpokes. Skylyn glanced around. The other hands and their dogs looked so big, so tough, so ready. Skylyn's heart was beating really fast. Was Baby's? Papa pointed as he spoke. You three circle to the north. Check the pond. You take the Bull and Brown Trail. Skylyn and Baby take the circle to the west. The rest of us will head to Flowing Park. We'll divide up there. Everyone nodded. Gather whatever cows you find and meet at the mothering grounds. Well, Baby, this is it, Skylyn said as she loped out. Baby was right behind, bounding over the tall grass. Meg shook her head the way dogs do when they are confused or worried. An hour later, Skylyn was upset. They'd ridden far. She'd used eagle eyes all the way. Baby was working hard, running all over on those short little legs, but they had not found any cows. How are we going to show them we are real hands? We have to find some cows to gather. Things were not looking good. Then Baby stopped, looked to the left. Skylyn followed his gaze. She spotted some movement over in the Quakies. Yes, cows. Baby, this is our chance. Do your best. Baby wagged his little poodle pom-pom tail. Skylyn knew to circle wide to the left. They had to work the cows out slowly. Baby knew to work back and forth behind the cows. The little herd started off pretty calm. Get along, little doggies, Skylyn chanted. But that was just the start. They rode into a meadow, and the yearling ran to the right. But Baby was there. He was all over that spotted hide. Baby brought that rank cow back to the bunch. Good boy. Baby jumped over a skunk cabbage and away they went. It seemed like hours, days, weeks. Often the cow would head in the wrong direction. Skylin would go out and around the cow to bring it back. At the same time, a cow on the other side would take off. Back and forth went Baby. Back and forth went Skylin. It was hard work, but on they trod. They had to get them all to the mothering grounds. There was not a clear trail. It was very rocky. Baby must be getting tired. Stay calm. Be cowgirl tough, Skylin told herself. Baby looked at her. She must have heard the worry in her voice. Skylin looked at Baby. We can do it. We're true cowhands. I said it, but do I believe it? She asked herself. Meanwhile, back at the mothering grounds, the cowboys were holding a rowdy bunch of about 300 head of cows. Meg and Homer were pacing back and forth. Were they worried about Skylin? Were they worried about Baby? Skylin and Baby should be back by now. Mama said a little prayer. It was a loud place. Mother cows were calling their baby calves. Baby calves were calling their mamas. Papa was watching. Where were Skylin and Baby? Someone yelled. It was a couple of cowpokes from the other ranch coming in with a little bunch. But it was good they were all there because they all got to watch Skylin and Baby come over the hill. They had made it with their cows. One cowboy said out loud, "Well, I'll be that kid and her lapdog have a gather." The other cowpoke's jaws just hit the dirt. Skylin heaved a sigh of relief and smiled as big as Texas. She looked down. "Back, Baby." Baby moved behind Skylin's horse, holding his tired little head high. As Skylin looked back up, though, a big bull broke out in the main bunch. He scattered her bunch. We could lose them all. Skylin almost panicked. Not right here, Skylin thought. Baby looked so tired. Homer and Meg automatically headed toward the mess. But Papa knew it was make or break for Skylin and Baby. Back, Homer, Papa ordered. Homer went to sit behind Papa's horse. Papa winked at Mama and said, they need to finish this on their own. Mama nodded. Meg, get behind. Skylin told Baby, way out. And Baby circled around and nipped at that big bull's heels. Skylin raced around to cut her cows back. Skylin had won a lot of barrel races, but she rode even harder to get this job done. Skylin and Baby gave it everything they had. The cowhands just watched because they had to hold the bunch and couldn't help. But after some fast running, after some quick turning, Skylin and Baby got every one of their cows under control, all by themselves. The Cross V crew and their dogs were grinning from ear to ear. All the cowboys parted their ponies. They tipped their hats as Skylin and Baby put their cows in the bunch. Homer and Meg seemed to sit tall with pride. That small girl and her little poodle had done the job. Done it as well as any grown cowpoke or official cow dog around. Papa rode over to Skylin. Thank you. He said it very loudly. Papa had a twinkle in his blue eyes. He nodded to Baby. Homer came over and with as much respect as a dog can show, sat beside Baby. Even newcomers and city slickers heard. Word spread. Every hand on the mountain talked. Talked about cowgirl Skylin and Baby, her poodle cow dog. Maybe that poodle set out to prove his name a mistake. Maybe he just wanted to be a border collie. Maybe he loved working cows. This will never be known. But the result is the best cow chasing, the best bull biting, the best poodle cow dog ever. Skylin and Baby worked every roundup from then on and still are. The end. And now, I'd like you to meet Meg and Baby 8 years later. They're right here with me today. We just finished working some cows, so they're pretty tired. Come here, Meg. Baby would love to sign your book too. He really enjoys coming to classrooms, and whether we're here in real life or on video, this is Baby, still alive and moving cows today. And if you want to order a book, not only will I put a special message to you, one that you can even tell me you want, but Baby will also dip his little paw in the ink and put his paw print in each and every book ordered, just as a special way to show you we love you and we believe in you.